How are you? I hope you all are staying safe during this COVID-19 crisis. So children, myself Asha Giri, and today we are going to begin the first chapter in 9th chemistry, and that is matter in our surroundings. So children, in our daily life, we see a wide variety of things in our surroundings. Say for example, if I ask you people, name any 5 things which you see in your house daily. Then your list may include the things like table, chair, bed, almira, etc. And to extend the same list, if I ask you that to give me the names of any 5 things which you see in your classroom daily. Then your list may include desk, this piece of chalk with which your teacher writes on the blackboard. Blackboard itself an example of a thing. Table again, the book from which you read, etc., etc. So children, these different things which we see from morning to night in our surroundings, and we not only see them, but we use them for variety of purposes. So these things in the field of science are given a technical name, and that is matter. Yes. So the various things which we see in our surroundings, these things are called matter. So how technically we can define matter means what is matter? So children, matter can be defined as anything which occupies space and has a mass. Means to call anything as matter, that particular thing has to satisfy 2 conditions, and these conditions are that it should occupy some space and it should have some mass. Say for example, I am holding a piece of chalk in my hand. So that chalk piece is an example of matter, because when I am holding it in my hand, it is having some mass, maybe 5 gram, 10 gram, etc. And when I am going to keep it over table, means at a certain place, it is going to occupy some space. So this chalk piece is an example of matter. Similarly, in this beaker, I am having water. So this water is also an example of matter, because this water inside this beaker is occupying some space and it is also having some mass. So anything which occupies space and has mass is termed as a matter. Right children? Now in our surroundings we see different kinds of things. Means everything is very different from another thing. So we can say that there are different kind of matters, and based on that we need to classify matter. So our next topic is classification of matter. Now children, regarding the classification of matter, 2 theories are there. So first theory is commonly referred as the Panch Tattva theory. And children, this theory was proposed by our ancient Indian philosophers. According to them, everything in this universe, whether it is a living thing or it is a non-living thing, everything in this universe is made up of 5 basic elements. Now the word 5, for that word 5, we have taken the Sanskrit numeral named as Panch. So these 5 elements are air, water, earth, sky, and fire. And not only our Indian philosophers, but ancient Greek philosophers, they also arrived at the same conclusion. They proposed the same thing, that everything is made up of five basic elements: air, water, earth, sky and fire. So this theory we commonly call it as Panchtattva theory. Now another classification or the another mode in which we can classify matter is according to our modern scientists. Now modern scientists, they classify matter on the basis of physical and chemical properties of the matter. So children, on the basis of physical properties of the matter, it can be classified into three groups named as solid, liquid and gas. And based upon chemical properties, we can classify matter as elements, compounds and mixtures. Clear children? So regarding classification of matter, I told you that we can classify matter in two ways. The first way is according to our ancient Indian philosophers, which told that everything in this universe is made up of five basic elements: air, water, earth, sky and fire. Another way of classifying matter is according to modern scientist theory, and they have classified matter on the basis of its physical and chemical properties. Okay children? Now after classification of matter, then scientists, they started to think that what is the physical nature of matter, means how does a matter look like, whether it is continuous like a block of wood or it has got granular nature, means it is made up of particles like sand. When we hold sand in our hand, we can feel its particle nature. So lot of cures were there. Scientists were discussing, no, matter is having the nature of continuous, means it is like a block of wood. And other class of scientists was saying, no, matter is made up of particles. So finally, after some experimental theories and calculations, it was finally discussed and concluded that matter is made up of particles, means the physical nature of matter is a particulate nature. Matter is made up of particles. And to show this practically, we are going to conduct one small activity, and that activity will clearly show that yes, matter is made up of particles. So children, for this activity I have taken approximately 100 ml of water in this beaker. Okay, you can see the level of the water, it is approximately showing 100 ml. Okay, now in this watch glass in my hand, I am having common salt, which is chemically referred as sodium chloride. So what I am going to do is, with the help of this spatula, I will add a small quantity of this common salt inside this beaker. So I have added 2 and 3. So I have added 3 spoons of spatula filled with common salt. Now by using this glass rod, I am going to stir this salt inside water. So children, basically what I am trying to do is to dissolve the salt. So when we keep on stirring it for a longer period of time, this salt gradually start disappearing. And same thing you might have observed in your daily life experiences. For example, when you prepare lemonade, which we commonly call in India as Nimbu Shikanji. Yes. So when you prepare that lemonade, in that also you add sugar, and when you stir it, the sugar disappears. Okay? Like. So now here, if you see, that I have added 3 spoonful of common salt in the beaker, and by using that glass rod I have stirred the solution, and now you can see the salt has completely dissolved. Now check carefully, is there any change in the level of water after dissolution of salt in this? Just check. No, there is no change in the level of water. Means before dissolution salt, the level of water in the beaker was 100 ml, and after the dissolution of salt, again the level of water is 100 ml. Then where that salt has gone? The salt which we have dissolved, we have dissolved in water, but there is no change in the level of water. Then where that salt has dissolved? So children, this observation can be explained by assuming that matter is made up of particles. Let's see how. So children, here I have made a diagram. So in this diagram I have shown, this is salt solution, this is glass rod, and this is beaker. Now water is also an example of matter, and the salt which I have dissolved in that beaker is also an example of matter. Now I am assuming that both water and salt are made up of particles. So basically what happened, when I started stirring the solution, then what happens, the fine particles of common salt, they broke down into more finer particles, and these finer particles of salt, they occupied the space which is present between the molecules of water. So as I told in the beginning, water is also a matter. It is made up of water particles, and these particles are having spaces between them. So these fine particles of salt, they occupied the spaces between the particles of water molecules, and because of that there is no change in the level of water in the beaker even after dissolution of the salt. So children, this activity clearly indicates that our matter is made up of particles. Okay children, so till now I discussed with you what is matter, then we discussed about how matter can be classified, then we discussed about that the physical nature of matter is of particle, means matter is made up of particles. Now children, these particles which together make up matter are very very small. These are so small that they are not visible to our naked eyes. Not only this, they are not visible even under a powerful microscope. And to practically prove that matter is made up of very very small particles, again we will conduct one more activity. So for this activity I have taken water in this beaker, okay, and in this watch glass I am having a purple colored chemical salt that is known as potassium permanganate. So for this activity I will add few crystals into this beaker containing water. Now as you can see that the crystal, they had already started imparting dark purple color to the water. Now I am again stirring this solution with the help of glass rod, and here you can see the intensity of this purple color is becoming more and more dark. Yes, now as you can see, the water in this beaker has become dark purple. Why? Due to the dissolution of potassium permanganate crystals. Okay, now children, this in my hand I am having a dropper. Now by using this dropper, what I am going to do, these are 4 beakers, and in these beakers I have taken small quantity of water. Now we are going to transfer that dark purple color solution from this beaker to the first beaker. Say for example, I have taken like this. So approximately I have taken 10 ml of dark colored purple solution of potassium permanganate, and this I am going to add in the first beaker. First beaker which is containing water. What is that few more quantity? Like this. Okay. Now if you see, the water in this beaker has become colored. Okay. Now I will take a small quantity of this colored water from this beaker and I will transfer it to another beaker which is already containing water. Like this. So I have transferred a small quantity of water to this another beaker. Okay. So children, if you just see, yes, so first I have prepared this potassium permanganate solution by dissolving a small quantity of potassium permanganate crystals in the water. Then I transferred a small quantity of this colored solution to another beaker. Okay, that was already containing a small quantity of water. And then from the second beaker, I transferred the colored solution to third beaker, which is already containing clear water. So if you compare and see, the first common thing in all these three beaker water is that they all are colored, but intensity is different. Means the first beaker is having the darkest purple color. Then the second beaker is having bit lighter and the third beaker is showing the very faint purplish tinge of the color. But still you can see the water is visible in colored nature only. So how it is possible, or how does this happen? How can we explain this observation? So students, when I added few crystals of potassium permanganate in this beaker which is containing water, then these potassium permanganate crystals, they got dissolved in a small quantity of water around them and they formed the solution particles. After that, by using this dropper, I picked up a small quantity of this potassium permanganate solution. So when I was adding this colored solution to this beaker, then few crystals, few particles of potassium permanganate were transferred into this beaker like this. It means a single crystal of potassium permanganate is made up of millions of particles of potassium permanganate. That's why even after taking a very small quantity from this solution, there were so many particles were there in the solution of potassium permanganate that they made the water of the second beaker color. Similarly, we took a small quantity of water from the second beaker and transferred to this third beaker. So from there, again few particles of potassium permanganate, they got transferred into this third beaker and they made the water color. And why the color intensity is different? Because in the first beaker, the number of particles of potassium permanganate are maximum. In second beaker, they are less than the first beaker and they are minimum in the third beaker. That's why the color is very, very light. Clear, children? So this activity clearly proves that matter is made up of particles, and these particles are very, very small. So children, in this first session of this chapter, class 9 chemistry first chapter, I discussed with you what is matter, how can we classify matter, what is the physical nature of matter, and third one, that particles of matter are very, very small. So I hope you enjoyed this session. And in the last, just one instruction from my side, children, that for your facility, our school, our society is uploading various modules and audio version of explanations for that particular module on our school website. Kindly refer to those modules, go through the study material, listen to the explanation, and do read your NCERT books. Do read it from line to line, every example, every activity. And finally, make your notes in your fair copy and do solve the questions which are given in your worksheets. So, with remaining certain topics, we will meet again in second video lecture. Till then, take care, enjoy learning.